Well, if Calgary withdraws, only two of the original eight 2026 Olympic bids remain, and the Olympic brand is being called into question. It's not what it used to be, and many voters in different cities right around the world are saying, you know, it's just not worth the headache and the hassle, and as is often the case, the big price tag that comes with it for taxpayers. To help us take stock of the Olympic brand, we've got marketing expert Brynn Weingart joining us from downtown Toronto. It is interesting, isn't it? Because I remember, and no doubt you remember, lots of people watching, when, you know, to get the Olympics was a big deal. Now, all of a sudden, it's like, no thanks.
You're right. And I think, you know, it's such a good point, too, Todd. I think with this, you're seeing a lot of different factors at play for Calgary specifically. But many cities saying, listen, there's the infrastructure costs are really high. There are, you know, there's scandal, there's security. Security costs that sort of follow around. Now, International Olympic Committee, one of the things that they have long rested their proposition and their return on investment has been around the idea of place branding. This idea that if you host the Olympics, later you will find that tourism is increased and that, you know, there is all kinds of more interest in coming to the city. But what many cities who've hosted the Olympics before have reported is that in actual fact, they're not getting those returns they thought they would, that legacy doesn't have the tail that it used to have. In other words, people aren't necessarily increasing tourism to those areas. And then, of course, if we look at Calgary specifically, tourism is not their main industry. So it's sort of not a surprise then that Calgarians might decide against this proposition.
And we know every time there is an Olympic bid, wherever it is in the world, Brynn, I mean, there's a lot of what's known as boosterism, where people kind of get into it, they drink the Kool-Aid, so to speak, and they really, you know, get into this idea of hosting an Olympics. But in reality, I mean, you know, as some of the critics have said, this is sort of a 10-day party and it's costing billions of dollars. We're going to show our viewers where things stand right now, because there were three cities, and Calgary's still officially one of them, but in all likelihood that's going to end. Stockholm and a joint bid in Italy by Milan and Cortina d'Ampezzo, those are the two left standing. And there are other cities that backed out before, and we're going to show these ones as well. And that includes Sapporo, Japan, that was in the running and then said no thanks. Also Graz in Austria and a place in Switzerland as well, all three of them saying no. So really it comes down to only two. What about the price tag here? How much of a factor do you think that is?
Yeah, so it's estimated that the Olympic Games cost about $5 billion or so, and that is significant. It certainly would have played into Calgary's concerns, an economy, of course, that used to be, you know, have all kinds of prosperity, et cetera, that has struggled in the last 10 years or so. But $5.1 billion is the estimated cost for these. And, you know, it's really, again, to that point of are we likely to see those returns come in through tourism, through people that will visit, especially for the Olympics? It doesn't have the draw that it used to, Todd. And so that proposition, again, starting to really, you know, become a bit of a drag for IOC, I'm sure.
And we have covered these stories extensively, Brynn, in, of course, the work that we do, all of the doping scandals and the corruption scandals and the vote rigging and the buying. And, of course, that does not do any good to the Olympic brand. What about millennials as well? I'm just curious whether you think that people who are, you know, in their 20s and early 30s, I mean, do they have a lot of interest in something like the Olympics, or is it old school?
Yeah, it's kind of, to your point, Todd, there is some consideration that this is kind of, you know, the way that we used to come together as multinationals, as multiple countries all together at once. Now, of course, with social media the way that it is and the way that millennials view the world, it's sort of a global landscape. And so we don't need that opportunity or that excuse every 4 years necessarily. And millennials definitely starting to see, or not necessarily realize the value, as you quite rightly point out, in something that happens in this scope and scale to this expense, when in actual fact, those athletes, those sports are things that they are trailing and able to watch year round through different media for sure. So that's also a concern, is that the youth today don't necessarily see the Olympics as the event that their former generations might have.
Wonderful to have you on, Brynn, and thanks for getting to our studios today to give us your take on the Olympic brand and its value at this point.
Yeah, thank you, Todd.